Good afternoon and assalamu alaikum. Can you all hear me or do I need to mind you? It's an honor to be asked to launch the poetry competition. At first, I got a bit happy. I thought maybe I could enter until I looked at the age restrictions. But it's Islamic Human Rights Commission are launching a competition, poetry competition on the theme of genocide. It's sad that the topic is genocide, but it's good to get young people involved. And the ages are from 11 to 18. And the winner will get, I'm told, a trip, an all-expenses-paid trip to Bosnia, so they can witness one of the most recent places, sadly, for the genocide to have taken place. And it's not just the child on their own, obviously, that would not be in compliance with health and safety. The trip, the winner, will also be able to take an accompanying adult also with them. And the poem can focus on any of the genocides that the young person has heard of. They don't have to be restricted to any topics or any countries or places that they heard of today, any genocide that they know about. And the closing date is the 8th of March, 2015. So until the 8th of March, young people can get around. And all the other details are available on the Islamic Human Rights Commission's website. The steps that lead to genocide. By definition, it is a tragedy that we have to gather like this, year after year, that we have to cry like this, reminisce like this. Genocide after genocide, after genocide, after genocide, after genocide, and genocide. That these years go by and mother's tears have not even begun to dry. I wonder, is anybody even left to bury the insurmountable numbers who die? Genocide is that which can never be unseen. That which has come and been. That which is scarred deep inside. That which should never have been. Genocide. The term genocide is oft preserved for those who are humanized, elevated to a level to be commemorated. But if you fall on the other side of the label divide for genocide, you don't qualify. If you're, say, from Palestine. If you're too Muslim or too black, then your lives just don't matter enough. A kidnap is a rendition, torture, enhanced interrogation. And your mass murder, why, that's just collateral damage. Your genocide is at most an ethnic cleansing. Like, as if you were dirt that needed washing away. The steps that lead to genocide begin with ripping out your inside, desolify you, classify you, stigmatize you, your mother, your father, your brother, your sister, dehumanized. And even our babies can now be criminalized. The steps begin with taking away your humanity, making your men monsters, and your women and children disposable collaterals. But who's counting? The steps that lead start with the casual racisms and the so-called phobias. The unuttered, unchallenged, harbored prejudice. Then begins the name-calling, the institutional exclusions, then the legal changes that apply to you and only you, the secret trials, the denials of rights, of hope, of freedom, of dignity. The steps that lead need to be identified and called out before it's too late. And many heads shake and ask, how did this happen? It happened because abuses went unaccounted. Free men were shackled and shipped and enslaved to a narrative set by those on a terrorist trip. Some media mouthpieces aided and abetted, stoking the flames that scorched the earth and the steps that led to the shaking heads and delayed remorse of the apathetic masses. Too black or too Muslim for their dictionary definition, and the hierarchy of victims of genocide began this way. Dr. King said, "Our lives begin to end the day we become silent about things that matter. This matters. You matter. We matter. Apologize," they say, "for things you didn't do. Assimilate," they say, "until you're invisible. Uncivilized," they say. Then your books are blamed, your teachers are blamed, your grievances delegitimized, your pain is neither here nor there. You don't even matter, not there, not anywhere, they say. The steps that lead to genocide must be identified and called out to cease and desist, or we will continue to be fair game. Our lives, fair game. Our lands, fair game. Our name, fair game. The steps that lead to genocide hide in plain sight. So we must open our eyes to the signs and our ears to the drumbeat that rolls, because the steps to genocide have been tread time and time and time again. So please don't ask me, how did this happen again?